What are you doing, Daryl? That's crazy. Alright, give me a minute. I need to open my monster. Are you hungry? Is that what you're asking for? Or thirsty? I'm thirsty too. Alright, yeah, he's thirsty. Let's get him something to drink. Yes, Monster Energy. Bottoms up. Maybe one more. Maybe one more. Maybe just one more. How about maybe just one more? There. Okay, now we can leave. What's up, Dream Master? Turning to offline mode. Why? Nice burp. Yes. Well, of course I don't have the necessary cargo. The last time I checked, it was on the bike. I don't know where the bike is. Alright, I put it in here. Look at it. It's so much more beautiful now. Hell, I wonder if I can change the colors of it. Well, it looks like I'm gonna have to deploy the shit again. Oh God. Damn. Redeploy order. Redeploy cargo. All right, let's try this. Take on orders. What is this? No. Well, I don't know what to do. At least the bike is fixed up. I hit redeploy cargo. Where is it? Oh, it's in the private locker. I didn't read that before. Okay. So, give me this. Load it onto the bike. Load onto bike. Load onto bike. Load onto bikus.
Woody, Woody, hello, cat. How are you doing? Yes.
Okay, let's do it, boys. Yeah. Here I come. Sorry, just taking a drag. Don't mind me. I'm sorry, is this thing automatically charging me? Oh, it's a level 3 generator. Cool.
Today's a good day. Thanks for the help.
Yay! Oh, I jumped. Can I change the music? I absolutely can. I wish that kind of stayed playing. I wish there was like a radio station on the bike. To where I could listen to all my music there. Ha! 3,000 meters. God damn, it's a good thing I got this bike. Let's just hope I don't lose the bike, because if I lose the bike, I lose the cargo. Then I'm gonna have to come all the way back just to grab the cargo again. No. What are you doing? Timefall, BTs, son of a bitch. Damn it! I lost the medical instrument. Oh well. Don't tell me I'm gonna have to make the rest of this on foot. Alright. Well, I knew this was gonna happen eventually. And of course, whatever. I can recall the bike at a different point on the area, right? Go away. I feel like I gave up too quickly. I know that there is a way to get this bike across. I'm just not in the right spot for that right now. I feel like I'm going the complete wrong way. My grandmother just came to say good morning to me.
Whee!
Okay, so I was in that time fall for quite a bit, so I'm worried about the degradation of the packages. Okay, maybe there is no way to get the bike. So maybe I should just start climbing up. Hey, that ladder's from me! Good thing this isn't time sensitive. I'd have failed by now. Oh, well, I guess I'm leaving that behind. Not that I wanted it in the first place. I know that there's a way to get the fucking bike over here. I got it over here before. I gave up too easily. Seriously, bro? Give me those fucking chiral crystals. Oh god. No, not Timefall, please. It doesn't even really feel like he's running. I'm gonna need some container repair spray. I'm gonna have to make a quick pit stop over here. Wait, do I have some on me already? I do. I'm gonna save it. What I need to do is I need to make a quick pit stop over here anyway so I can call my bike. I don't even think I can call my bike over here. And there's a fucking generator in it, I needed to charge it too. Ha! Fucking hilarious! Can I call my bike here, please? Oh, I can't fucking call my bike here. I feel betrayed. Bro, I'm gonna need my bike to make this. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. God damn it, dude.
I'm there.
Way station west of Capital Knot City. I'm like right there. I might as well pick this up and deliver it. Alright, fine. Fall over then. Let's see if I care. I tried my very, very best to keep you on your feet. And you didn't even grab that package. I swear, one of these days, you're gonna fall off of something doing that. And I'm not gonna be held responsible for how many broken bones you get. Oh, no.
Wah!
Oh my god, wah!
Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. Cargo verified. Thank you.
BB, calm down, honey. It is okay, baby boy. Girl, whatever the hell you are, I don't care. You're fine.
Truly are incredible.
I try. Cool.
All right then. Good work.
And I can't call my bike here. Do nothing and close. What the fuck do you mean, do nothing and close? Oh. Okay. Here, I don't know what the fuck they want me using these blood bags for, but I don't need them. Yeah, I know, I won't be able to get them back. Getting kind of bored. I wasn't even moving the button anymore, and he was still walking. Use this as a weapon. I'm gonna use it as a fucking weapon. I'm gonna beat somebody's head in with a fucking scalpel. I've already been through this area.
There we go.
People are unconscious. Do they just not wake back up? I guess they don't wake up. I guess they're just dead. Ooh, I can rob this place of their container repair spray. Daryl, come on. We are losing precious cargo integrity here each time you bump into something. Each time you conveniently lose your balance and bump into something, we lose precious cargo integrity. Thank you.
sheep.
Can I save now? Still too far into mule territory. Now I'm going into BT territory, so now I won't be able to save again.
Too close.
No, oh, I didn't mean it.
Another way of describing the connection between you and another porter. If you want to forge a powerful bond, consider a strand contract.
Oh. Okay. Okay. So this just makes other people's cargo easier to see. Well, I can't think of anybody else I'd want to form a strand contract with in Madrick. This guy at the bottom is like what I aspire to be. Delivery volume at 73. Jesus Christ. Golly. All these people have such good stats. I haven't been reading any of these. But we're almost ruined. Yep. Oh my god. Put it down. Okay, now I can save my game. Okay, good. A hologram of a Karen will appear wherever you or other players are resting. Resting near a Karen will increase the speed at which Sam recovers.
Whew, not a moment too soon.
Yep, we need some of that monster. I wasn't actually ready. Pressed the wrong button. So you can just sit your happy ass back down.
About to drop.
And take a nap. Yes, Sam. I'm permitting you to take a nap. I have a therapy appointment today at 12 that I don't really feel like going to. Alright, we'll recover the rest of the stamina from Monster.
rest for the wicked.
Or me, for that matter. Ugh. Fuck! No! Fuck! Son of a bitch! Goddamn! My god, I've only crossed 1,000 meters so far. Without my bike, this is gonna... no. This time ball is gonna fuck these packages up. Oh my god, I have to get out of this. I have to get out of this. Yeah. Oh god, there's so much cargo around here. That did anything. It turned it red. There's a private room over here, I think. ETs should be letting up. Okay. Woo! Gotta get this cargo. Now we can call our bike. None. No bike. Zero. It appears to me that I have lost my only vehicle. I see. Okay. I've got to go and get that bike back.
Begin scan. Footwear condition poor. Replacement is advised.
Alright, give me a minute. I gotta go and use the restroom, and then I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. Okay, so I have a decision to make here. I need to go. I either need to go back and get my bike,
keep on keeping on,
or I need to keep on keeping on and make this the rest of this delivery on foot. My bike is halfway back in the other direction. I just need to keep going.
Footwear condition poor. Replacement is advised.
Okay, let's go.
Beginning scan. Footwear condition poor. Replacement is advised. Keep on keeping on.
Who is calling me?
Sam, it's Hartman. Your friend and fellow doom sufferer. our affliction, such as it is, began with the beach, or rather, our discovery of it. Once, the question of life after death was answered only by religion and philosophy. But when we learned of the beach's existence, death became something more tangible, knowable. The living soon walked the shores of the afterlife, while dead things, beached things, began to find their way back. And then came Dunes, and with it a host of theories advanced by physicians and psychologists, desperate to explain the world's newest mystery. The symptoms were to be categorized and stratified into levels. But repatriates like you are a singularly rare breed, worthy of a classification all your own. The specialists must have been climbing over one another to get a look at you. I wonder what they found.
Oh, but nothing. What is this supposed to do when I go across a river? Is it supposed to help me cross? Okay, well, it didn't help me cross. I feel like I'm gonna play something different tomorrow morning. Come on now. Oh my God. Come on. Oh my God. There's so many rocks to slip and fall off of. I wish it was, like, designated where timefall areas were. Is there a way to, like... Oh, shit. No, I need those. They're gonna take me under. Yeah, they're taking me under. My cargo! Oh my god, they're really dragging me out into deep waters. Alright, let's just go. God. Get out of this rain.
God damn.
I don't imagine I've got much left of this repair spray. Okay, that was something. I need better boots. Come on, Daryl. Come on, you seriously can't climb that? Oh my god. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. How much closer? Only a little bit farther. I'd say about 1,000 meters. Less than 1,000 meters in range. Uh. Almost there.
Getting some shot.
Now how the fuck do I get all the way down there without killing myself? Well, there it is. Port Knot City. Wait, what am I talking about? I got a climbing anchor. Oh my god, dude. The soundtrack. Oh my god, dude. How did this game not... Wait, did this game win, like, any awards? Because it had to have won something for soundtrack. If I take another fall, I'm worried BB will... Oh, yeah. Oh, BB! I'm sorry! I knew I should've used that climbing anchor. It's okay, we're almost there. Just stay with me a little bit longer. This run has taken a lot out of both of us. Don't stop. Don't even think about stopping yet. We're not even close to our destination. Well, we're there, practically, but we gotta deliver this shit, and then we can rest. Just so they can't tell me anything about, like, the condition of the cargo. There. The condition is probably much lower than it seems. Okay, there it is. There it is.
CB! Here, take this.
You the porter? The one-man army sent to the workman team?
I recognize you.
You have 2 feet to fill all them boots. Looks like everything's more or less intact. About what I expect from a guy running solo.
I recognize you. You're the dude from the beginning who just tried to stab himself. Yikes. Well, at least I got it done. I got an A for the order. Ah, yes. A new song to listen to. Delivery volume. Went up by 3 levels. Oh my god. 4, 5, 6 levels. Oh my god, bro. How much delivery weight did I just get? 50 plus. I don't know if that's like.
So you heard of usher us into a new chiral age or some shit?
Yeah. That cool?
Hell yeah, go for it. Been waiting forever and a day for this.
Didn't he die during, like, the beginning of this? Alright, now we gotta go rest for BB. Oh yeah, that's really cool. What happens the closer and closer we get to the western region? And like, we get into all that bad shit over there. Yep. That's really cool. My BB died for this.
You get that little guy?
I found him off the side of the street.
Same as mine. Where the hell did you get it?
Yeah, I can't really say. But the little guy, he came with the pod, if you gotta know.
And who'd you get the pod from?
Igor, from Corpse Disposal.
My little brother.
That explains why he looks so similar.
So, what? He just gave one of these to you. Why?
I was there with him, at the end. We were moving a body. Things went to shit. There's BTs everywhere.
Yeah.
And one of them grabbed him. So he told me to take it and run.
That right?
Yeah.
So what's your story?
I'm just the guy trying to deliver.
Like that, only to keep on doing the same work. Okay. Been a long time coming, I suppose. You take good care of that little guy.
I'm trying to.
He belongs with the expedition. With you.
Alright.
Poor little guy.
With you too, I reckon.
Probably suffered from autotoxemia like 3 times ever since he's been with me. Whereas he's been opposed to a perfect life. Probably perfect delivery. Amelie!
Portnot City is back on the grid. This community, a part of the UCA. Their data, a part of our shared wisdom. With enough time and enough chiral printers, they'll be able to build ships. And one day, the waters will be ours again. All because you led the way. The one who follows in your wake isn't always good. Any city that joins the UCA becomes a bigger target for the terrorists. But we have to accept the dangers and press on, no matter what. The rest of America is waiting, Sam. Waiting for you to take the first step and connect them to the chiral network. I know you can reach them.
Yep.
Make us whole again.
We are just one small step closer to making these the United States of America again.
UCA, huh? So, you fixing across the lake and head west?
Yeah. We got a boat?
No, not for years now. Terrorists took out everything, bridges that float. Only boat in town belongs to a private courier.
Private courier? Don't tell me. Fragile Express?
That's the one. I already spoke with their rep.
I'm
having them load the boat with some of the supplies you brought us. I'll bet the folks in the lake Knot will be tickled pink to see someone come into port. Been a while, I expect. Head on down to the harbor when you're ready. It's right outside the distro center.
Okay. So now I gotta make my way all the way back there.
Knot never gets the rain.
Uh-oh.
Feel free to rest up in your room before you head out.
Oh yes, please, because I need to really check on BB.
Your work is bringing you appreciation.
Yeah. I did that. God, poor little guy, I'm so sorry. Just kind of pass out onto the med. It's fine. Okay, cool. BB pacified. Goody. I'm awake.
Good morning, Sam. Blood collection complete. Thank you for your generosity.
More and more guys are showing up back there behind me. Okay, let's read some of this mail that I got. Read this one. Ever since you told me about my brother, I haven't been able to stop thinking about him. I want to make one thing clear, though. I don't blame you for what happened. Igor wouldn't either, I know that. It's weird, though. We weren't all that close, and back when he was alive, I'd go weeks without thinking about him. But now, well, ain't that the way these things go? You still got that little keepsake of his. Sounds kind of stupid, but I started thinking of it as his alter ego or something. You know, it was his dream to go west with the second expedition. He never made it, but his favorite toy does. If his favorite toy does, it almost feels like it would make up for it, at least a little. You show the little guy the sights now, you hear? Lord knows I'll never get to see them. How are you doing, Sam, and how's your BB? Me, I'm a bit worried, that's why I'm writing you, actually. You see, I just have a BB of my own back in the day. I can't be bothered to read these out loud, so if you guys want to read them, knock yourself out. I'm probably going to read them out loud because I can't help myself. Thing is, and this is just between you and me, I started to care about my BB. Yeah, I know, I went to all the briefings, it's just equipment, don't empathize, don't get attached. Yeah, well, easier said than done, especially when it gave me a like. Piece of equipment can't do that, right? Equipment doesn't like being rocked around either, or get sued by the sight of a spinning Odra deck. Check out your tips if you're not sure how to do stuff like that. My BB loved it when I took us swimming, when we just float on the water, but got real scared if we dove in or went under. Like a tool would give a shit about any of that. I bet your BB's the same, right? Reacts to things in ways that can't be explained away. Man, I miss those days with that little guy. You'll take care of your BB, won't you, Sam? What am I saying? I know you will. I'm trying. Hey, Sam, sounds like you're showing us all how it's done. I've been making more in deliveries myself. The oxy really helps to cope with the fear, so thanks for that. Don't get thinking I got ice in my veins or anything. I still panic easily, and I still drop plenty of cargo when I do. Doubt I'm the only one, though. Tried to do the right thing and drop cargo. I feel like saying fuck it and letting it lie. What goes around comes around, right? I hope someone recover lost cargo. Someone will do the same for me. That's how bridge links are formed, after all. Most of us will never be legends like you. No shame in that. But if we put work together and make connections, well, we can at least make the world a better place. And that's where the bridge links come in. Together we can accomplish so much more than we could ever on our own. And that's the truth. Still keeping on, Sam. Me, I've been practicing going outside and longer and farther each time. Thought I'd conquer my fears at some point. Nobody's been as long. And I can drop damn near everything I was carrying. Guess it belongs to them now. It's a little hiccup aside. Watchtowers. Managed to put up a few signs and watchtowers and other stuff I figured out guys like you might appreciate, so it's not all bad. Haven't met any other porters face to face yet, but I until they're... It's a feeling like when someone hits you with that like, it's a feeling like no other. Yeah, it really is. That confirmation that you've made a positive difference in someone else's life, it's grand, man. Anyways, good luck with everything. Sending all the love and likes. Dear Sam, I wonder where you are right now. If it's somewhere powered by our wind farm. If anyone should be benefiting from our work, it's you. Until you brought us into the network, we could only provide power to a small region. Now we can send it to all of the big cities and beyond. I'm still not 100% on the details, but basically transmitting it via the beach means we don't suffer any additional loss due to increased distances, so we can go as far as we need to. Good thing we kept the faith in the second expedition and kept this place properly maintained. You've made our efforts worthwhile. We can't thank you enough. I hate these fucking long ones. How are your porter grades these days? I'm sure you're aware that I'm trying to account to all five factors is the basic premise, but if you're anything like me, you just want to deliver as much stuff as possible. Am I right? If so, you could always just load yourself up with a massive haul and aim for a bridge's bonus for total cargo weight. Nothing wrong with the simple approach. Of course, in the good old days, it was easier. Roads were much better back then, so all you had to do was check in your stuff in the back of the truck and go for a drive. Can't do that now, though. Even if you got a truck, they're usually more trouble than they're worth. Hell, sometimes you'll just see them sitting on the side of the road, locked and abandoned. Anyway, on the bright side, since lugging big loads of cargo is so hard these days, folks are really grateful when a porter manages it, hence the bonuses. Here at the distro center, for example, we have to make sure we got plenty of food and materials in stock, which means we're here to make every delivery count. I dread to think what would happen if we ran out of supplies. Well, I've said my piece, and now you know how to make yourself popular around here. Stack your cargo. Oh my god! Sam, how you doing out there? For a newbie, you're quite the workhorse, huh? Timefall's probably taking its toll on your equipment, am I right? Maybe some of your kit's not even possibly usable anymore. Well, don't jump the gun and throw that stuff away just yet. One thing you could do is turn your old equipment into a delivery circle and recycle it. You can then fabricate yourself a shiny new whatever to use instead. Don't know if you're aware, but the whole recycling system is operated by a Bridget Strand Foundation. That's right, the president herself set it up as a means to convert busted tools and gear back into reusable resources. On the other hand, if your equipment's only halfway to broke out and you still want to part ways, you could use a share locker to donate it to another porter whose use need is greater than yours. You may well end up getting a like or two for your generosity, never mind the warm fuzzy feeling of having helped a fellow man. Of course, the system works both ways, meaning you can snag stuff other porters have put in share lockers too if you're the one who could do with a helping hand. Both recycling system and the share lockers have their uses, and it's up to you to pick which method best suits your needs at any given moment. You've still got a lot to learn, I guess, but you'll have it figured out in no time. I've got high hopes for you, kid. How's your BB doing? I hope you've managed to avoid autotoxemia altogether.
About that.
By the way, I've been wondering, how are your porter grades these days? Getting better and better, I imagine, or maybe you don't really care about that stuff. Well, in case you do, I thought I might give you a quick primer, since I know it can be quite confusing. Bridges has developed a unique system to evaluate porter performance, and it focuses on five main categories: cargo, condition, delivery volume, speed, bridge length, and miscellaneous. Obviously, the aim of the game is to get high grades in all five categories. If you ask me, you should prioritize cargo condition. I mean, what's the point of lugging around something halfway across the continent if it's smashed to bits in the process? Sure, some people aren't all that bothered. Some will even let you get away with up to 50% damage. But come on, imagine if you ordered a dozen thingamajigs and half of them were delivered broken. No, it's definitely better to put condition first. Treat your cargo with care and respect, and you'll be awarded with way more likes. Trust me. That's my motto when I was a porter. It wasn't always easy, as you can imagine. Sometimes things got dicey, but I learned to hang in there and deliver my cargo in one piece. You do well to bear that in mind, Sam. After all, you've got potential to be way better porter than I ever was. You're goddamn right. I just... really gotta get this shit down. I'm gonna have to read all of these. I probably should have been reading all of these. Imagine if I could just flip through the DNA, or like, the information this quick and actually assimilate it at that speed. Well, I'm gonna have to find a good time to start reading all of these. Now is not a good time. What are you guys talking about? I don't want to read all these right now. I want to play the game more. So cute. Hello, little guy. Oh. Boo! Don't scare him, Daryl. It's okay, little guy. I'm sorry for making you a god, Otoxima.
Tired, huh?
Yeah, I would be too after that long ass ride. Hell, Daryl still looks like he could use a shower. Okay, skip the shower scene. Still gets the shower scene. Skipping the shower is the whole point of... Not seeing this is the whole point of skipping the entire shower. I just want to see the part where he comes out. I know that, like, this helps make weapons and shit that the game will probably want to tell me about, but I don't really care. The butt shot is not worth it. Number zero, huh? Yeah, he took a shower. He gave us a little wink. It's nice. Alright, before we go out... just kind of drink all the monster on his desk. That way we're ready. Let's go. Probably gonna get like a memory flash from BB or something.
Brought you an astronaut.
Oh, it's nice! Thank you, Papa!
Mankind can go anywhere.
Really? It's cool, Dad.
No time. And the second all this is over, I'm gonna take you wherever you wanna go.
Okay, there's gotta be a way to call my bike back without having to go all the way back over there and just finding it and putting it back in the garage. How do I fabricate vehicles? There's gotta be a way to, like, fabricate an entire bike, right? How to unlock the bike? Maybe it's in the locker. Deliver lost cargo. J Jake Wind, George Baton. It looks like the Tinkerer. Wait, is that the Tinkerer? I think that is the Tinkerer. Yeah, that's the Tinkerer from Spider-Man. Miles Morales. Wait, so how do I fabricate? I don't have the option to fabricate vehicles. That's so weird.
Hello?
Pleasant journey. Beginning scan.
Oh my god, I thought they said that Port Knot City never got the rain. And there's fucking BTs? Oh my god, dude. I've been lied to. Oh, I'm about to get taken away. What's happening? Why aren't they eating me? Oh! You! My profile picture! Bro.
My name's Higgs. The particle of God that permeates all existence.
Cool.
Ah, so it was you that dragged him into all this. Bloodied but unbowed.
Uh-oh. Where'd she go? Ah! Whoa! Hi!
What's that?
Are you sniffing me?
Strand is dead.
How can you tell that just by sniffing me?
President dead and burned. Oh, and now the girl's been chosen to take mommy's place. Well, that won't wash. She's not cut out for politics, is she? Oh, but don't worry. I'll find her. And I'll keep her real safe. You see, I've come to understand the truth of the Death Stranding. Oh, there's so much you people don't know. The girl, for instance. She's not like you or me. Dooms ain't her thing. And she's more into destruction on a worldwide scale. An extinction entity.
Bro, even your bridge baby looks evil.
It's so hard to form connections when you can't shake hands.
I know, right?
Fortunately, I've got a good connection to the other side. Now you, you're no bridge. But me, I'm bound to all of it. This world, that world, and our sweet little angel of death.
Oh my god, what is he doing? What is he doing? What is this thing? Is he making something? Oh, good God.
You're a menu. All it'll take is one itty bitty void out to blow us all to kingdom come. So how about it? Aren't you getting tired of the grind? Isn't this what you've been waiting for this whole time? A game over.
Okay.
Heads up, Sam. According to our damage assessments, it'd only take a single void out to total Fort Knot City.
It's got a gold thing on its face.
To make contact with the civilian would be enough. We can't let that happen. You've got to deal with that BT right now.
Okay. Then how the fuck do you want me to do that? Ow. Oh my God, it's kicking the shit out of me. Oh, it actually has a health bar.
Get some rest before you drop.
I'm gonna die, bro. I don't know what you want. This thing is gonna kill me, and then it's gonna wipe out this entire city that I just tried to fucking get on the grid. Thanks. Oh, they even threw me a pneumatic grenade. Text is black. I was like, don't tell me it just made me respawn from my last checkpoint or something. Cause I don't know where my checkpoints were.
According to our damage assessment, it'd only take a single void out to total Fort Knot City.
Eliminate the BT.
One BT allowed to make contact with the civilian would be enough. We can't let that happen. You've got to deal with that BT right now.
Thank you. Come on. Come on, almost got it. They're all empty. Why are they still on my back if they're empty? Okay, I think I got it. Catcher Crusher. Eliminate the BT. Oh my god. Elimination BT. I got an A on that. We need you. And I got a trophy. Fuck! Been awarded the title, more deliveries will earn you greater trust and respect. And I'll receive more likes. Oh my god, dude.
Incredible. Simply incredible. For the first time in history, a human being has defeated a BT.
Yeah, I know.
If you were a patriot, I doubt it would have been possible. Not only does contact with your fluids pose no risk of triggering a void out, but in much the same way as your car is rejected by the beach, your blood can be used to expel BTs from our world and return them to the other side. You've given us hope, Sam. Perhaps we may yet be saved.
Yep, no need to thank
me. Proud, my friend. Amelie's still waiting for you in the west. Head to your boat. It's ready.
Oh, fucking hell, finally.
We're just getting started.
It's about damn time. I can probably pick up all these chiral crystals. I got so many chiral crystals now, oh my god, bro. I went from like 100 to like 1000 in a moment's notice. Alright, so my grandmother wants to leave at 10:30 so that she can go down to the bank and get some money out. So we're gonna have to leave a bit earlier. I may get on something else. Don't know. They should call me Sam Porter, the Demon Slayer. Alright. I'm gonna need to rest in the private room after that. Holy shit, dude. BP pacified. more mail. Might as well knock that out now. Hey Sam, you've heard the latest rumors that Capital Knot City people have been seeing some sort of weird glowing thing up on the rooftops near the isolation ward. Seems it's Ka, the part of the human that doesn't turn into a BT. That's what people are saying anyway. Apparently there's a common sight back in the old days. Back before the stranding, I mean. Story goes that they were lost souls wandering around. One of my pals tried to go take a closer look, see what's next, but he couldn't find anything. I'm sure you could do better if you put your mind to it. How's it going, Sam? So you put Port Knot City back on the map? Not bad. Folks around here have been pretty pumped up about becoming part of the UCA and all that comes with it. Chiral printers especially. You should have seen their faces when I gave them a demo. It was like conjuring equipment out of thin air. Before I forget, I should also thank you for all the stuff you brought and for taking care of that BT, too. You've given everyone a shot of inspiration and courage to carry on. There's not much that there's more precious than these days than that. Oh my god. There was a time when I was so shit scared of BTs that I just wanted to shut myself away and hide forever, but that's not an option. I know that now. We're on the front line here. Bridges ain't gonna like it. There isn't any way to step up our game, but don't worry, we won't let you down. We got poor nonsense back in the day. Maybe throwing in the towel. Same goes for you, right? No, I'm not throwing in the towel. We won't be throwing in the towel. Yeah, you're absolutely right. I won't be. Well, if I'm gonna read through some of this data that I got logged, I'm gonna need music. Bridges' primary objective is to rebuild America. In order to rebuild, one of our tasks is to reconnect any... I can't read it. I don't feel like reading. Ooh, I got a new thing on my table. I got a new dude. I kicked the fuck out of him. Time to drink all of my Monster to celebrate. And now for a shower to clean up. Monster! Yes, Godofson. There is Monster. Welcome to the stream, my good man. Good to see you. The little baby.
That's it, Lisa. Don't be shy.
Gwendolyn is a femboy?
Like we used to.
Totally agree.
Come on. Keep up.
I fell on his ass.
Sorry. Did I wake you up?
No, I was already awake.
Today's mommy's birthday.
Oh, today's mommy's birthday. A disappointment. Gwendolyn is a disappointment. Hey, look, I have mixed... I hate Gwendolyn extra because of her being a Covenant leader. Or it. Whatever Gwendolyn is. Female, femboy. Female, male, femboy, I don't care. I hate Gwendolyn. I missed out on a trophy because of Gwendolyn. He is a guy. Ah. So that makes it worse. So it is an actual femboy. Alright, let's go. Don't be so serious.
Gonna catch a ride on that boat, Sam?
Yeah.
Before you do, Be aware that you'll have to leave behind any cargo you haven't gotten around to delivering. It'd be a shame to abandon something important, though, especially if you were close to finishing a run. My advice, put that stuff in your private locker in Port Knot City. Or, if you're feeling responsible, you could just delay your boat trip until you've tied up loose ends. It's your call.
Damn it. You up for some ER later? Probably. We'll see how my therapy session goes and if I feel like playing it after. I'm not delivering anything right now, so could I go? Then again, I do kind of want to get on something else. Alright, should I advance and take the boat ride? Or should I stay here for a bit? Should probably stay here for a bit, but I don't know. That's why I'm asking you guys. Well, I'm assuming this is like a major plot point in the story, so I'm gonna just call it here. Gonna call it here then. Probably get on something else. Just for a time. I'm gonna go into the private room. The first thing I want to start on in the next episode is I want to get all that information that I have yet to read. Like all the shit that I've been getting this entire time, like the investigations and whatnot. I want to get all that. And I want to get that read before I make my next move. And I also want to do any deliveries, I feel, before I move on. Just in case, it might help me out a bit. Plus, I'm not ready to move to an entirely different region if I still have shit to do in this region, considering how freakishly massive this game is, and how long it takes me to complete just one order. So, yeah, this is gonna be a big game, but I'm fully committed to playing it. So thank you guys for tuning in, those of you that tuned in live. If you liked it, please share me that by hitting the like button. Subscribe. Turn on post notifications so that you never miss another video and you'll be notified when I start a live stream. And hope to see you guys in the next one. Make sure you guys share this video with everybody you know. It really helps out with the channel and helps it grow. And as always, if you're not crazy like me, you're not normal. Peace out. I love you guys.